Hello everybody and welcome to Qi Gong practice. Now today I'm going to make this Qi Gong session the same as it normally would, so exactly the same moves, the same warm up, but I'm going to make it slightly shorter. So I'll call it Qi Gong Express. Yeah? So maybe it's a chance for you to get back into fitness and just do a shorter version for what you would normally do if you practice Qi Gong already. Or for those that are looking for a workout to do in a short space of time, but still get all the moves. Yep, so let's start with our warm up. You can see I have no shoes on, I've just got socks on, and I'm on a wooden floor, so it's nice and easy for me to transition from one move to another. And but whatever you feel comfortable in, but make sure that your room is cool on the cool side, but you don't want it too cold for Qi Gong, yeah? So what we're gonna do is start by rubbing our hands together, yeah? So just gathering some energy and warmth, and just being aware that we're just trying to settle down, get nice and relaxed before we begin, okay? Take the shoulders back away from yours. All I want you to do is work from heels through to toes, yeah? So if you need to hold on to something, grab a chair by your sides. We're working from heels to toes and we're spreading out the feet as we do. So again, spreading out the toes. Couple more. And last time. Let's take that shoulders down. Feel the length between the ears and the shoulders. So we're nice and lengthy through this part. Your arms are nice and loose. Yeah, in front or at the sides of the body. We're just going to take the head slowly side. Warm up, this is really important, and we're properly warmed up. Now take the head back to center, tuck chin to chest, and back up. Two more. Oh, that feels tricky. Into the shoulder blades, up towards the ears, slightly backing down. If you want to add breath, breath in, breath out. And then opposite, if you've got pretty with the coat on. Hopefully we get rid of those soon. Couple more. And I like to do one back to reset them back in position. Okay, hands up in line with the waist, like bending knee. Twisting. Side, side. I'm trying to keep my hips straight, but mobilize the top half of the body. Side to side. One more time each side. And then back to center. There we go. And to the other side. That's it. Each time we're trying to get a little bit further down the leg. Sit a little bit higher up into the arm. One more time each side. And last time, we're into our spinning plates now. So palm faces up, slight bend in knee. We try and spin that foot right round overhead. And back to the start. Try the other side. So imagine you've got that plate in the hand. You don't want to drop it. You want to spin it round over your head. And back. Excellent. Wonderful. Mobilizing the shoulders. And again. Round it goes, round overhead. Try not to smash your plate. One more time each side. And last time. There we go. So that's the upper body nicely mobilized into the hip area now. We'll go bend the knee again and we're circling off these hips. Get these hips nice and mobile. Before we begin, our work. And then the other way. Over. That's it, nice and loose. Take the feet a little bit wider than you normally turn. Both toes turn slightly out, shoulders back. Now imagine this chair behind you tempting you down. So take the arms forward as you park your back side in that imaginary chair. Now as you come up, you can maybe try and come up onto the toes. So you have to though if your balance isn't good. And again, you could be holding onto the chair in front. Couple more so you can get a little bit deeper to activate all those big muscles in the legs. That's it. And last. Well done. Last part of the warm-up. I'm showing you from the side. The shoulders come back again. Trying to keep a straight line from head to tail. So I'm trying not to curl over. Yeah. If I don't reach the toes, it's fine. Yeah. What I'm trying to do is stretch out the back of the legs. So that's the aim of the game. Not to see how far we can bend over. Bend. Yeah. Straight line, head to tail, shoulders back. Nice breath in, breath out. See, I'm trying to keep that straight line. I don't get all the way down the toes. That's fine. I come back up. Plant that foot on the floor. Turn to that side, shoulders back. Nice deep breath in. Again, I'm going down. Doesn't matter if I don't get to the bottom, as long as I'm not curling my back to do so. Shoulders back and down. Now if I was to bend my back here, oh yeah, I'd touch the toes, but I wouldn't be stretching out the back of the leg. And that's the aim of this exercise, is to stretch the back of the leg. And one more time to finish off. Shoulders back, breath in. Breath out. So see what you're doing there is stretching out, targeting the back of the back. But it doesn't have to be that you go all the way down the toes if it compromises your back position. Okay, shake it all out. Yep, shoulders back and down, and we begin our practice. So I want you to imagine that your arms and hands are weightless, obviously. Don't do that with your legs, you might fall over. But we're trying to keep facial muscles relaxed, shoulders relaxed, arms and hands nice and loose. It keeps the strength in the lower portion of the body and the core. So take the shoulders back. All right, start with lifting water, raising the arms up. And back down. If you want to add breath, breathe in and up. Breathe out and down. Now how far do the arms need to go? Well, it doesn't really matter if you can only get them so far, so you just there. Just take them down again. But if you can, reach all the way up to the ceiling. And back down to a good stretch. A couple more. Breath in. From there we're going to open your chest. Arms up and around your chest, open wide, back into center, and again. Big stretch there. Start to the weight of your feet if you need to. Yep, so we're going up to the forehead now. So we take the arms all the way up to the forehead. At the top, part the clouds wide, round and down. So breath in. On the heel, this leg, the foot is on the floor. I bring one arm up, put a bend over from the hips, up through the center, transfer all the way up to the other side. If you want to add breath, breath in, take up, breath out in. Painting a rainbow, this one's called. And again, it doesn't matter how far down you get. Yeah, we're just trying to keep that straight back. as opposed to bending over just to get that little inhale. One more time each side. Fantastic. That will get the heart rate up a little bit more than the others because of the bigger moves that we're making there. Our next one's into rolling arms. So slight bend in the knee. Palm faces up. Take a big circle behind the back. Over, through, and down. Same on the other side. Palm faces up. Big circle behind the body. Through, over, and down. Add in the breath if you can. Breath in. Breath in. Just make sure you're breathing and concentrate on the moves and getting the move right. Big circles. Let's do one more time each side. Last time. Well done. Shake it out there. From there we're going to be looking at the moon, so we're over in this direction again, up on the heel. Yep, so this knee has a wee bend in it, and I tilt back, I'll look up to open palms, signifying looking at the moon. And that comes down, travel around, tilt back, looking up in the open palm. Let's use the breath here, right? Maybe not. Breath out. One more time each side, or just rest if you need to. Last time. And rest there. Okay, so the next part of the sequence, we blend one move into the other. Yeah, feet wider than you normally stand, shoulders back and down. So you remember in the warm-up, we imagined there's a chair behind us and we sat down in the chair. This time we're going to spread our wings at the same time, but we're going to keep the heels firmly on the floor. So hands in line with chest, sit back and down, spread your wings, come back up and gather back in. Just take your time. If you want to, add the breath in and out. Breath out. Breath in and out. Flying wild geese. We'll change it to a dove in a minute. So take your time. Okay, making this your next one, your last one. Instead of coming up, step out this way. Spread your wings, gather back in, up in the heel. Down you go. Breath in and up. Flying dove spreads its wings. One more to this side. Gently and slowly transfer that over to the other. Step out, spread your wings. Gather back. Forward and down. So moving on to the next one, which is Spire the Dragon. Now ideally with your feet together, but if this feels too wobbly for you, just take them a small way apart. Yep. So if you can, feet together, if not, small way apart, hands to heart center. So we're going to make a figure of eight in line with our shoulders. Yep, and then we're going to work down and work back up the body. Yep. Pushing the hands together for some extra work. And making a figure eight on its side. So terminology would be an infinity. Yeah, I think. That's it, twisting and turning. Now this is the easiest option. You might find the other options a little bit harder, so you can go back to this one if you feel it's too much for you to go to the next one. So the next one is bending the knees and go either side of the waist. Twisting and turning. Bend the knees again, we're going either side of hips. So beginning to work the big muscles in the legs. From there I'm going either side of knees, yeah. So you're really working hard now. Sit in the ear, requires me to use a lot of the thigh muscles. Some of you this might be too hard, so I'd make your way back up. If not, if you can manage, come back down with me all the way to the bottom. That's it. Up to knees. Up the hips. Up to waist. Side of shoulders. And finally, all the way up to the top. And then rest the hands in front of the forehead. Breath in, take up. Breath out, take down. Separate the feet. Well done. So we're going to do one more version of Spire the Dragon from bottom to top. So you decide where you want to start with. I'm going to start all the way down the bottom. Some of you, it might be the knees or even the hips, yeah? So if we can, start with the hands and feet together. You're going to take a nice deep breath in first. As you breathe out, lower yourself down to where you want to start from. Okay, nice deep breath in. Lower bottom. No particular breathing pattern for this one. Just breathe up to knees. Up to hips. Up to waist. Up to shoulders. And find either side of head. Resting hands in front of forehead, breath in, take up, breath out, take down. Well done, excellent. Okay, shake out the legs. We're going to move into a more relaxing piece of the practice. It's called rolling the parallelism. So you want to imagine you have a ball. We start off at one side of the body with our precious ball. Come around to the other side. Transporting the ball from one side. So you can close your eyes if you wanted to, just try and imagine the energy that might come through your ball. Or if you feel too unstable to do that, just follow your hands with your eyes. It should have a nice calming effect in rolling the pearl of wisdom. Think it was a precious ball, a ball that you wouldn't want to drop. Just a few moments longer, just enjoying the peace. You, I feel nice and relaxed in the upper body anyway after that one. Okay, bring you back to life with two final moves, pushing water, yeah, the first one of the last two. So step out to the side, push down towards the floor, bring it up to ceiling, yeah. Push down towards the floor, bring it up to ceiling. If you want to, you could add in a breath. Pushing in and up. One more to the side. Slowly and gently move that over to the other. Push down. Ball. So maybe just today's up on the toe as far as you can go, or if you feel more adventurous to really challenge your balance, taking the foot off the floor. You're probably better on one side than you are on the other. No particular breathing pattern here, just concentrate on trying to balance on one leg. It takes a while to master this one, and we can always improve on it. Enough, then just stay up for a little bit longer before you transfer it. Spread the toes out. That's it. So lift in the ball. One more side. One more to each side to finish off. Finish off, we'll take hands and feet together. Breath in, take up. Breath in. Last time. Breath in, up. Breath out, down. And finally, hands feet together. And tilt the right finish. Well done. I hope you enjoyed today's express version of Qi Gong. A slightly shorter version than you would normally do in a full class. So say if you're thinking about getting back to exercise, that should be a good starting point for you. Or if you just want to use this video clip for a morning routine or something in the evening to calm you down and just stretch yourself out after the day. Thank you very much for joining me. Until the next time, bye-bye folks.